Hello folks, welcome to another evening of League of the Sea. I'm here like always with Seka.
Hi all.
Yeah, tonight's game will be Skunk versus OP. Yeah, quite well. Skunk we covered or casted on Sunday, so the ones who watched it might be familiar with them. OP we didn't discover yet, I think, but they are a clan that is existing for a while now, since last year I think, even more. OP took part in several King of the Seas, if I recall it correctly.
Yeah, like I've definitely seen them play before, also met them a couple of times in randoms, so they're quite well known in my opinion.
Indeed, indeed. Yeah, first of all, I think over the stats and stuff, that's your resort, so...
Yeah, we have like become, we are becoming quite the League 3 specialists. But it's, like this week it's really one of the only options we have to cast, because clan battles are dropping this week as well, and both of us will be playing that. Then you have to play on Thursday yourself in League of the Sea.
Exactly.
There's a patch, there's the Halloween event. Like, there's a shit ton of stuff going on this week, so, yeah. Like, we don't know if we get a second game this week, but we wanted to do one game, and this is the one that is tonight. So we are featuring League 3 again. And also, it's, like, the game for the top spot, so to say. Because League 3 is a very, very tight league at the moment. Like, there are 5 teams who are super tight and super close, inside of, like, 2 points. OP, DSW, PTS, Skunk, and MFG. Like, all of these have 12 or 10 points. So, basically the first two spots are free for the grab, so to say. And it's the halfway point of the season. Like, today is the 5th match day. And therefore, it's quite significant. And also, like, on Thursday when the patch drops, like, every other match that is played after Thursday or on Thursday is having to deal with the smoke changes.
Hey.
That are coming. So... the competitive meta will change even a bit more than it has already changed. Like, we've seen the rise of the Charmatel in, like, the last 2 months, and it will be, like, very, very different, in my opinion, and not as static as it is at the moment at the top leagues. Because you cannot just hide your battleships in smoke any longer. At least not if there's a DD close by or something. That is going to be punished very, very harshly then. And, yeah, we will see who learned the lesson and who didn't.
Yeah, let's see if we learned the lesson then on
Thursday. We will find out on Thursday, or rather you guys. I'm not playing, but you are, so I will definitely watch that.
Yeah, I'm happy I'm playing the Shal most of the time, so I don't have to deal too much
you
with
don't,
the
you don't have to worry smoke. About smoke most of the time, it's true. Okay, but back to the game of the day. So Skunk is in 4th place at the moment, sharing that with a lot of guys actually. All of them have 10 points, and all of them are aiming for overpenetration, OPs, 12 points, who are sitting at the top. So, in an ideal world, or like in an ideal scenario for Skunk, they win all 3 maps today, and then they're first. Like, no questions asked, they get the top spot then. OP definitely doesn't want that, so they want at least one map to, like, retain their lead. So, it's going to be, like, a tight match. Hopefully the both clans or both teams are really tight in skill as well. Let's actually take a look at the stats on WoW's numbers now. Skunk we've already featured now, like, last week. Was it on Sunday?
It was on Sunday, yeah.
Yeah, so 2 days ago. Stats obviously didn't change that much. So they still have, like, a very good, like, win rate, almost 60% overall. And personal rating of 1.7k. And like we mentioned last time, only 21 members, so they don't have the advantage of, like, the 30 members. But therefore, they're a very tight-knit group. So their communications are really on point. They know each other quite well, probably playing in divisions a lot. And therefore, like, that's basically their thing, that they only have these 21 members and they're not actively looking for members. So they want to stay these 21 people at the moment. And on the contrary, OP, full 30-man roster, bit higher personal rating, but the win rate is a bit lower than Skunk's in overall. And if you see a look on the clan leaderboard, both of them are very close. Like, win rate is 25, place 25, to 35 for OP. Average damage, OP is in the lead, 20 to 34. And personal rating, 37 to 31. So, yeah, these clans are definitely on one level and comparable, in my opinion. So, should hopefully be, like, close games that are fun to watch. And we will see. Like, we have seen OP play before. Like, we kind of know that they have very interesting tactics and they make them work. And you know the maps already for today?
Yeah, I just got them mailed. First map, Warrior's Path, from OP side, Southspawn. Map 2, Sea of Fortune, Southspawn for OP again. And map 3, as it is the map of the week, Southspawn again for OP. So,
yeah, I like the Southspawn then. Okay, okay.
Get the info, the room is up already.
Room is up, okay, so we're looking for Warrior's Path first. Yes, there it is.
Also want to mention, if you like to get streamed by us, you can leave either me or Seka a private message. So, yeah, maybe yeah,
just,
we can arrange
just write
to
us
do
on Discord or something. We will definitely see it then.
Exactly. By the way, did we post? on Discord that we are streaming.
Let me check. Holy fuck, so many. I guess so many things. Like my windows at the moment are looking atrocious. Streaming. Nope. Yeah, are you writing?
I'm okay. Writing it. Just tell them to put me on. I think I'm going OP first, and then I can write this in calm.
It's quite significant. Okay, I wrote them. Stream is up for both of us, I hope. As usual, we have like a 5-minute delay, so there's no advantage for both of the teams. And both perspectives, like one perspective on your channel, the other one on mine. One is A to the K, 101, and the other one is Sofa Gaming.
Exactly.
So, let's see how this goes down. It looks like OP also has like their own like
maybe they're just watching, I'm not sure.
Oh, okay. So but Limerax already said like spectators are not allowed. Because yeah, that would be a bit unfair.
I mean, should be fine if they are like on their sides, I would say.
Yeah, but then Skunk has to kill like two of the guys. Like, two bots or something.
Yeah, true. Oh, he's going to stream.
Don't know if there are any routes for that, we will see.
I'm not sure, but Lilmarax should know it, I think he's...
Yeah, that's up to them, actually. So, but are you excited for the patch?
Well, yeah, kind of. Of course, Clan Wars, it's...
Because I think it's going to be pretty awesome. Like, the Halloween event looked very, very nice from what I've seen so far.
Yeah, of course, that's the thing.
Also, the Primer Camos
that looking...
you can earn.
Yeah, well, I didn't see that one. But yeah,
they are damn nice. Like the Shukaku gets a perma camo basically. It's a giant bat sitting on the flight deck basically. It's looking super awesome, and I'm totally looking forward to that. Like hopefully I can win it or earn it, because it's RNG based what you get. So you might be suffering a lot with me through these missions. Just warning you already. Yeah, and the other camos, like the Bismarck camo, looked nice. What else have I seen? I think there was a Benson camo as well. So, yeah, they are all pretty damn fine.
Yeah, well, I didn't see that yet, so I'm quite uninformed. Pictures after.
Like, usually, I'm the one who's reading forums and, like, Reddit, and you are just playing the game.
Yeah, there's some discussion now about this streaming and
the spectators. Actually check if the what the rules say about spectators, because I have the streaming and sportsmanship. Oh, there are a lot of guys already joining the document. Okay.
Yeah, as I said, Lil Marax should know it, so. I'm pretty sure he's telling the truth here.
I don't know, like, I haven't seen anything specifically towards, like, spectators. Is there anything about spectators in this? Because I'm not sure. I mean, if you get, like, a dispute, there should be some admin online somewhere.
Yeah, the thing is just, he could have, like, the one who's guy who's streaming could have, like, easily go into the schedule doc and just put himself in there, and that would be fine. Yeah, we are ready.
Yeah, good luck and have fun all, and let's see how this works out.
Yeah, this is going to be exciting, that's for sure.
Let's take a look at the lineups on the loading screen. Hopefully everybody's loading in, because we know client is kind of iffy about that.
Okay, first difference I see is OP is going with a 3DD setup, while yep. Skunk is going double Lu Yang.
Double Lu Yang against double Lu Yang and Akizuki, okay. So not putting much value on the Benson in this matchup. Then we have two Amagis for OP against the North Carolina and an Amagi for Skunk. And then once again the Edinburgh, Chamotel, Atago, Kutuzov. So no Raider.
I don't know if the Edinburgh has radar, but I doubt it. I can't Maybe. Remember if he... Oh,
last time he didn't. Last time he had smoke.
Little Marx didn't load in yet, so might crash.
Okay, maybe. Did they say anything about restart something? But we want to die. We need to die.
Of course it is.
It's always worth it to kill you. I want that. Okay, yeah, Limerax is sitting here.
Yeah, there must be a call soon, if there is an issue. What came into my mind when I checked the Skunk roster, Echolon, last time...
Okay, Limerax is moving now.
Okay, Echolon 2K is playing Atago instead of DD last time. We can remember in the same
map. Right.
He played here at C for his life, and he did a great job against PTS.
Yep.
So, I'm starting first.
Where also, I'm not sure if Jester played the last game. I don't think so.
No, I can't remember at least.
Also, Fire Steve. So, yeah, Skunk with a couple of new members, like a different lineup today.
Yeah. So OP is going with Kutuzov, Akizuki, Amagi to A. One Lo Yang besides Chapayev to B, Amagi, Atago, Lo Yang going for C, it looks like.
Okay. Skunk is going for a very heavy A push, like the one of the Lo Yangs, Tuzov, Atago, Chamotel, and Amagi are there. So I think the Atago, Chamotel, and Amagi are kind of a roaming group. And Lo Yang, Edinburgh, and North Carolina going for B at the moment. Also, both teams are playing Chicago today, and it looks like both teams are actually having, like, a fighter setup.
Yep.
So, no big surprise there, no Enterprise today. Also, I saw, like, a recent video, Farah put it up. He tested the Zeppelin. Was quite fun to watch in competitive.
Johan made a mistake here. He lost his one fighter over B.
Okay. I've actually played against him, I think, a couple of times in randoms.
And Honrubia also got chunked as Chapayev.
Yep, he was visible and immediately got punished by the battleships. At least by one of them.
Life of a
Chapayev. And I think actually Hex might have shots on him soon. Because the North Carolina is actually going for a bit of a flanking position here. I'm not entirely sure about that. But we will see how it works out.
Nothing is spotted going C from your side, is that correct?
Yes, there's nobody there. Like, only the North Carolina is in the general direction of there, but he is turning for B soon, I think.
Okay.
Fire Steve in the meantime got punished. Probably by someone you know, the Amagi. Like, he's down to 30% HP, probably.
Okay.
So that was kind of costly to... Like, he wanted to back up the Luoyang, who's keeping A at the moment. And yeah, then he got big hit. Yep, and the Chamatel and Amagi are together with the Atago, who is really far away at the moment from everything, flanking.
Yeah, I wonder why they don't go for A. Ah, okay, OP is retreating from A for whatever reasons.
No, like, maybe, I don't know what they saw, but there's a very strong force from Skunk at A. So they have kind of secured that.
Yep.
Kingpin kind of needs the AA support of the Edinburgh at the moment to get rid of the torpedo bombers, otherwise he will get dropped here. Yep, there is the drop.
That's the issue in the Luoyang. Oh, he's taking one. Two!
Two.
Oh, that's significant.
That's, you don't want that.
Yeah, that's the issue with the Luoyang. It has no defensive AA.
Yes.
And against rough or good players to take a chance.
Yeah, Hex also needs to retreat here now, because he's getting pushed from C. Getting set on fire.
Yeah, the Skunk C flank was a bit too open.
Yeah, there was no C flank, basically. let's see what Kingpin
is. Oh, Lil Morax in his Edinburgh is up.
Oh, okay, that's
not
bad.
Not anymore.
Okay.
But Kingpin is still up.
Yeah, Kingpin is getting pressured. Like, he was air spotted, now he's probably raided at the moment. And he needs to get out of there. Even if they lose B for a bit.
Yeah, I think they need to regroup a bit.
Yep.
Question is, when is OP intending to stop the A push? Because that needs to happen at some. Ooh, Akizuki eats one torp.
Oh, there, okay. Those torps were kind of random. Probably RPF torps.
Probably, yeah.
From Jester. So, pretty nice that he hit one of those.
Yeah, always helpful. That equalizes a bit the chunking of the Luoyang.
Yep. Oh, both Luoyangs are now spotted at the moment. Yep, the Edinburgh is actually running radar.
That's what I meant.
So, Lil Morax bringing the radar, Edinburgh.
Yeah.
And yeah. I think the both Luoyangs are a bit surprised at the moment because they just like turned around. Okay, let's go. Like, I don't want anything to do with this.
Okay, there's some heavy pinging, where to go and whatnot, and so on and so on.
Oh yeah, the Akizuki was up briefly.
Yeah, but Kutuzov smoked up. So and that's a really critical moment. Do the Chamatel and the Atago have a DD with them?
No.
That's...
They don't.
Then they will pay the price. Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, there's the Chamatel down, Hoshi.
That's what you... The Kutuzov is the perfect counter for that.
Yeah, you can just stop the push, basically. In its tracks.
Why the hell did the Kutuzov just left the smoke?
Maybe scared of torps.
Yeah, but then... Therefore you have a CV.
Yeah,
I don't understand that, actually.
I mean, let's see. Maybe Lucha can like equalize it. Salvo coming in. Nope.
Grato was too
angry. Only one hit. Yeah, it's looking a bit rough for Skunk at the moment.
Okay, Edinburgh gets Hydro now.
Yes.
That's a pretty offense.
He's Hydroing back, but there are lots of OP
ships.
There's
nothing that can, like...
Stop. Also, once again, the top armor squadron is coming in. And I think Johanna definitely wants to go for the Edinburgh here.
Nope. He's going for Leia.
Looking for dropping for Jester?
That was a bit too early, that drop.
Yeah, I mean, Jester saw it coming there, so he paid attention. But I don't think I've...
Oh, yeah, sure Jester yeah really Neil wants... eats the Torp from Jester.
Yeah. But I'm not sure if Jester wants to fight all of these guys.
Probably not.
Because he just shot his out in the open. Now there's Hellraiser, Pac-Man, and Diano. And Janilla is also on the other side, so...
Yeah, but Janilla... has bigger issues, I think.
Yeah, he is being chunked down as well.
He has a fire and can't repair.
Down to 2k, so he will be visible for a long time here. Or he's... Maybe he's dead. Just dead. Yeah, if the Edinburgh gets out, one more salvo.
Yeah, there we go. Dead. Yeah,
oh, he's dead. Only one of those hit.
Whoa! He's not dead, or... one salvo
coming?
Okay? Yeah, he's dead.
Okay. Katusa, Fire Steve. But, yeah, Jester and Kingpin are both not looking healthy. Like, both of the Lo Youngs for Skunk are super low now. 3.6k and 1.6k.
Yeah, this is interesting, because they don't have, like, this south to north split. No, they have this east to west split of the map.
Yeah. And... like, the Atago and the Amagi, they are now chasing someone you know. I'm not sure if they want to do that, really. Because the Amagi is not a great ship for, like, pushing and chasing. Like, you kind of wanted to play in a more, like, defensive role.
Yeah, the issue is you can't do what they are doing right now without a DD.
Yep. Like, they have no protection at all.
And so... since the Charmatel got, like, deleted there already...
Yep. Like, Pac-Man on the other side, he has the support, basically. If they make use of it. Like, he has the Lo Yang in his, like, vicinity. Could smoke him up.
Kingpin is spotted.
Okay.
Yeah, but that's... The question is why Hellraiser is staying there in such a... stationary position. Something.
Jester was also up. I think Jester is, like, raided or something. Was. I mean, Lil Merax is in a pretty comfortable position, actually. Like, he can Hydro from there. He can probably even Torp the Amagi, who is now getting dropped.
Two Torp hits, probably Torp, flooding.
Probably flooding, because it was in the nose.
Okay, repaired. And also Edinburgh Torps.
Eating more Torps. Like, Pac-Man is going to eat more Torps.
Well, that's bad.
Oh no, they are expiring. That was okay. Because otherwise those would have been like 3 or 4.
Yeah, Echelon almost down.
Limerox, that was a bit too close with the Torps. Like, he tried to be fancy and launched them single around the island, but two of them actually caught the island.
Yeah, that's interesting. I mean, OP needs to get hold of this this cap now.
Yeah, or they kill like one or two ships more. Because they, like, the HP advantage is definitely with OP, but the points still ticking for Skunk at the moment.
What is Hellraiser doing? That's the question I have now. Shot some bullets, now he's, intentionally grounding there.
Kingpin needs to play this really, really carefully if he doesn't want to die. Yep, Hellraiser shooting him now. Yeah, and Echolon goes down in the south.
Yeah, that was like, and OP can like push now on this side. And that's an issue for Lil Merax.
The A group should have turned around a while ago.
Is Lil Merax down? No, he's not down.
No, no, he is raiding at the moment. Just sitting there. But he has coming torps from his own team on.
But OP's positioning is not so great.
Limrox needs to be really careful here. Like, he's so playing with fire.
He's sitting full broadside. I mean, the Amagi will have an easy time. Yep.
Pac-Man dodges the torps, but gets set on fire again.
Limrox can't do this, what he's doing right now. He either has to play aggressive there, really aggressive, going in, trying to delete the Luoyang, or he is pretty much in big trouble. Yeah. That's two torp hits.
Yep. Yeah, it's like Skunk is really playing with fire here. Like, Fire Steve is also
kind of one shot. But look, Pac-Man plays is almost down.
True. Yeah, if they can get him down, then that would be nice for them. Yeah, he's and down. There's the top drop. So, goodbye. Yep.
So now OP has to do something.
Drop by Psycho Eddie.
Okay, they are capping now. Otago is going the other way around. Makes sense.
The Otago is actually in danger of eating torps if he continues to push there.
He's waiting.
Yeah, Kingpin torp basically his path. Okay, but they are contesting both caps now.
I mean, Limorax is a bigger issue, I would say.
Yeah, that as well. Like, Hellraiser doesn't really know, okay, what do I do here? Reverse might not be a good option.
Yeah, you can only... Yeah.
Because there come the torps. Like, he's definitely going to eat one.
The thing is, it's such a passive play that the result is that they do even more mistakes.
And if he gets set on fire, again, no?
I bet on that Skunk will take this.
But Lucha is going to die now. Yep.
Okay.
He was in a really bad position, got like outflanked by the Amagi, the Kutuzov, and the Akizuki. Yeah, the A push was basically doomed to fail because they had no DD support there. And Limerox is also in trouble because of that. Because he can be shot from two sides now.
Yeah, he has to do something. That's what I...
Yeah, come the AP.
He should have done it like 2 or 3 minutes before.
Yeah, because he has the Amagi and
he
the
can't stay
in
there.
This flank now.
I mean, he needs to push at any cost.
Basically dead.
He waited too long. That's the issue. The Chapayev was not in a position to shoot him.
Maybe he can trade against the Otago? He should be. His torps are out.
Oh, okay. Yeah, he can.
So, kind of a best case scenario for him, but still. Like, they will not keep the B cap because the Chapayev is now just going to enter it.
Yeah, true.
And then OP has like 4 minutes to win this from points perspective. And
yeah, Skunk can literally just try to kill ships.
Yep. But yeah, OP conserved the HP pretty well compared to them. Like, both of the remaining DDs are above 50%. And both the Luoyangs of Skunk are, yeah, below 10. So there are a lot of one-shot targets around.
God.
Yeah, Kingpin. What did you forget?
I still had the browser up.
Nice. I didn't ask today because I was pretty certain that you had everything under control. I'm amazed that Kingpin actually survived this engagement against Diano. But there are more shells. Yeah, okay. Like... Skunk is in a really, really bad position here. And at the moment I would definitely give this game to OP.
Yeah, I mean they have 3 caps now, but yeah. Like... 5 minutes ago, that was really close.
Yeah, not yeah. I would even go like further, like saying 2 or 3 minutes. But after they stopped the A push too late. They should have turned around there at the latest point when the Charmatel died. But they kind of missed that opportunity and that spot. And that's why they lost the entire flank. Okay, is Hex going to find the sweet spot between the tops? Nope, he is not. Okay, there goes game one for OP. So they are taking Warrior's Path.
Yeah, also, sorry for like failing again. But the next
it wouldn't
games...
be one of your streams if everything would go smooth. Like, this is.
Yeah, that was the issue was this time that I was like watching the game and put the like post in Discord and then didn't check if I switched it back. It's always the same. I need some alarms in my chat or something.
You need
sounds.
Basically a moderator in your room, like next to you, who's checking that everything is running.
Yeah, indeed.
That's like the one thing I cannot provide. But in the future, like I will actually open your stream again as well, and then I can check for you.
Yeah.
Okay. Quick look here. Obviously, like OP killed more ships. That's pretty normal, but looks like. Psycho Eddie had the more successful air game. Like, I think Johan was actually pretty close to being deplaned. Because the Edinburgh killed 25 planes, that's quite impressive.
Yeah, as I said, Edinburgh has, or I said it on Sunday, I think Edinburgh has quite good AA if you
spec for it, yeah.
Sure.
Yeah, Hex also, like, 14. The rest of the team didn't kill much. Yeah, Lo Yang's obviously. The Def AA is definitely missing from the Benson.
Mm-hmm.
And on the other side, yeah, Johanna and the Akizuki doing the work. But yeah, pretty close first game. Like, it was on knife's edge, basically, at a certain point. And then OP just pulled it off. Like they.
Yeah, I'm
like the advantage that they had was basically Skunk not sending the 1DD with the Amagi force, and that those guys like stayed down there instead of turning back.
Yeah, interesting thing was like the push through A from Skunk. That was actually not necessary.
Yep.
Because they could have like fortified their C flank or put some forces there and then just keep B.
Yeah, that would have been like my choice as well. But we don't know like what they communicated there, like why guys continued to push. Because chasing a fleeing force that has smoke and even two smokes, because the Akizuki as well as the Kutuzov was there, and that was kind of known that because they were unaccounted for. So.
Yeah.
You have to like guess, okay, it's pretty damn certain that they are going to be there. You're running in two smokes, you don't have smoke of your own, and also you don't have the DD spotting. Like, you have the carrier spotting for you, sure, but that's only going so far, because you cannot, for example, spot close to the Kutuzov because of the AA.
Yeah.
And the Akizuki as well, because like he's even a bigger threat. That's also something that's getting changed in the next patch, luckily. Akizuki can no longer AA stealth fire. Like in the future, when its AA guns are opening up, it's getting spotted.
Yeah, nowadays you just know that there is an Akizuki around.
Yeah,
because
nowadays
you're losing, your
planes are just dying until you are like inside of like 5 kilometers and it has like 7 point something kilometers range.
Oh.
It was always a bit ridiculous.
Alright, be right back. 1 minute and
sure.
Then we can go on. All right.
Game is up. So, Seer of Fortune, we haven't seen it that often yet. I think only one time.
Mm.
So far.
Yeah, indeed. We played it, so Wargame paid to win. Against... who was it? Not sure.
Okay, Skunk for you, OP for me this time?
Ah, against you of R it was.
Okay.
I just had to recall it.
I think I didn't watch that one, yeah. Hmm. The maps are kind of a similar size. Or as powerful as well as Seer of Fortune, but Seer of Fortune is like tighter in the sense that there are more, like more islands and that the islands are actually closer together. So it would be interesting if Skunk is going with like a flanking again and if they like realize it like sooner this time if it doesn't work or if they are being like kited.
Mm. Yeah, flanking is always, you don't want to push. In general, in this game, right now at least. I don't know how it is after next Thursday.
Yeah, might change on Thursday. don't know yet.
It could be that this change on Thursday will... what's the word for it? Reward aggressive plays.
Yeah, because you can no longer just sit and smoke and hide and like wait until the enemy is like inside of like 5 kilometers to you. Like you can always just... throw shells at them and they don't have to move. That's going to change because you will be spotted sooner now.
Yeah, that's the thing.
Especially the battleships, like they will no longer be safe in smoke.
Yeah, I think that will favor like teams like U of R that you usually play pretty aggressive.
Yep. We are ready.
Because they could have like fortified their sea flank.
Okay, or let's see. Second map. OP leading 1-0. Let's see if Skunk can make the comeback here.
My choice as well.
Or if OP is like continuing their streak of wins. Because they haven't lost a single match so far.
Really?
They have won all.
Not even one?
Maps, I don't know, but the matches they have all won. Like they have 12 points. After 4 weeks,
yeah,
so they have won
maps.
All of their matches. So, okay, lineup. Two Amagis for both teams this time. Then we get the Charmatel, double Chapayev Kutuzov combination for Skunk this time against Atago, Chapayev and Kutuzov for OP. And then Akizuki, double Luyang against Akizuki and one Luyang. So, basically, no huge changes, but small
Ekalon
changes.
Ekalon is in a DD now.
Yeah, okay, that is a change.
And it's an Akizuki instead of Luyang.
Yeah. And yeah, the double Chapayev is also kind of a big change for like Skunk. But on the P side, like the DDs are still like the same players as well.
We saw this double Chapayev thingy going on Skunk.
Yeah, against PTS when they played.
True. I think they like to use this when there are like tight maps, as you would call them.
Yeah.
And
when you can bring them into position and like basically make a sure kill then out of something. That is what they're trying to do.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay, let's see how it plays out.
Chester and Luyang, Fire Steve. Kutuzov are moving towards C. Akizuki is moving towards A. That's interesting.
Yeah, Raven is moving there as well in this Akizuki. As well as the Amagi from someone you know and Hellraiser in the Atago. Like those three are basically the A group or like the go around A group, depending. Because I'm pretty sure that the Amagi doesn't want to actually go in there as well as the Atago. Like, they have no business in there.
Not initially, at least.
The rest of the guys, like Yanil, or Yanila, is actually behind B, close to B. And the other Luoyang and the rest of the cruisers and the remaining Amagi, they're going for C. Hex is visible at the moment, and Ekolon is now spotted as well. Because he just murdered that bomber squadron.
He's a bit hesitant what to do, it looks like.
I don't know if, like, what Skunk can see at the moment.
Just someone you know, too. And, Lucha and Hoshi and his Char Martel and Amaki, they are with Ekolon. But they need some time to go around to be in this pesky flanking position.
Yeah. Okay, looks like Skunk is already in C. At the moment there's nobody there to contest that.
Yeah, last spotted Luoyang was at B from your side.
Yeah, that is Yanil.
So we have... Yeah, they have a Doom Snail here, double Chapayev and Kutuzov. Someone copied UFR here.
Feels like. Yeah, let's see how it works out. I mean, at the moment, looks like the Chapayev and the Kutuzov are spotted here from OP. Kratos and VDFF. Yep, taking a bit of damage, but no. Ooh, VDFF actually beached. I don't know if he's still visible for you.
No.
Okay, then he's lucky because he's just reversing. There's an Amagi up there who can shoot him. Like, he hit him once. And I think Hex just shot again. Because he just popped up again. Yeah, there. The shot's coming.
Psycho got, like, strafed a bit here by Johanna.
Mm-hmm. Like, the fighter battle is pretty furious. Overseas. Yep. And Hex just found Kratos in the smoke.
Oh,
but not
Psycho is following these planes. No, not that anymore.
No, he pulled out.
So, okay. C-cap on...
Ekolon is visible, and Ekolon has a problem now.
He has no support, that's the main
issue. Yes, and Raven, someone you know, as well as Hellraiser, are all shooting him now. Yeah, Ekolon is pretty dead, I would say.
Doesn't he have a smoke there?
He has. And he definitely needs to use that.
The issue with that is, like, everybody knows where he is in the cap there.
Yes, like, there's no way for him to get out there.
He needs to wait for the torps incoming. Needs to definitely dodge them and then just turn around and piss off. And when the Luoyang is coming, then he's, pretty much dead. But yeah, you can't cap A without closer support. That's the issue.
Yep.
And the Charles and Amagi, I mean, someone you know is in the middle of this area around A cap. That's the thing I wouldn't recommend.
Ekolon is actually now up. He's hydroed by Yanil.
Yeah. That was about to come.
Oh, yeah, Ekolon, I think he is dead.
C cap gets also, like.
Like, there's no way for him to survive this.
The issue I see here with Skunk and double Chapayev Kutuzov, they have nothing, no really a spot where they can shoot at something. I mean, the Luoyang can just easily cap C and can't be...
I mean, Yanil traded like 50% of his HP for that, but I would say that's worth it.
Yeah, of course it's worth it.
So, you get rid of one of the two DDs?
Yeah, Skunk has only two DDs, so that's one DD down.
Yeah. And they end up capping, or like contesting two of the caps. Diano is actually kinda safe behind where he is at the moment. I am not sure if he can be shot. I think he's... Is he radared?
Dano?
Yeah.
Yeah. But okay, as I said, they have no shots.
Yeah, okay, then he's pretty safe there behind that island.
Exactly, because they are all lined up behind that island, but it's not really recommended. They should have like put some more effort in finding out which position is favorable for them on this map. Because you wanna have, if you have two Chapayevs, you wanna keep them shooting and not like sitting behind a rock all day long doing exactly nothing.
Yeah, Jester is not trying to push him out there. Or maybe get Janil actually down. That might work.
Wow, how did Janil eat so much
he
damage?
He got dropped by the Chapayevs and the Kutuzovs.
Ah, okay.
When he was like hydrating Ekalon.
Okay, then it's not over yet.
No, definitely not over, but it's still kind of hard. Because losing the Akizuki in the very beginning is like not recommended.
The Doom Snail is moving forward. That's interesting. But where are they going? That's the question. Okay, now they have a position that is actually really prominent. Yep, it is.
Lucha and Hoshi are bailing now at A. That's the right decision. Because Lucha is actually getting dropped, but yeah, defensive fire.
I think they could play aggressive in a way, but they don't need to if they can get the B cap. Jester is, I think. What is he thinking here? He's not going into B yet. Okay.
Nope. Jester turned just around, like back to the smoke. Maybe for a resmoke or something. And
what I don't like is that Danu is trying to get C. They have two caps now. They don't.
He's not really trying. He was just trying to like top them in the smoke. And he is bailing now.
No, there are the torps. Oh, oh.
I guess it's like Fleet Commander was yelling at him, get the fuck out of there. They have like, oh, VDFF and Kratos actually, they have to kind of push against Hex now. And they're not safe.
Oh, Lil'Marux eat the big thing there from Pac-Man.
Okay. Are the torps hitting anything? Yeah, Lil'Marux is visible. No. Fire Steve as well now.
Torps are fine.
Okay. Yeah, but Kratos and VDFF, like, they have issues. Because, like, Kratos is smoking, but they're not staying in the smoke. So, that was like a wasted smoke there. And... okay.
Kratos is not spotted.
No, but he smoked and drove forward with that, and I think there was a bit of miscommunication. Because now Diano, like, needs to use the smoke for them. Like, to smoke them up there, and they are still in radar range then, definitely.
Yeah, that's not what you do.
VDFF popped his radar now, so everybody is visible, like Lil'Marux, Kingpin, and Fire Steve.
Yeah, and Jester is going into B from north.
And there comes the first salvo. On the Kutuzov.
Yeah, that might hurt. But Pac-Man is
Pac-Man is probably paying with his life. There, because there's a lot of stuff flying in his direction. Yeah, I think he's down.
Repairs? Does he have fire ticking? No.
No, he just repaired the fire before, so now he's dead.
Now he's dead. Okay.
No, now he repaired, okay. Thought it earlier, but... yeah, will not really matter in my opinion. 600, 700, and there we go. So that's one Amagi down, that is a big advantage, and there was an airdrop torpedoes in the smoke that are killing Kratos. Really fucking well done from Psycho Eddie. Like, there was no air cover around there, so no defensive was popped, and he, like, Psycho Eddie could just drop in there.
That's good.
Because everybody was focusing on Jester, who, like, even the planes from Johanna would... all of them were in B, like looking for Jester, trying to kill him. And he just took the opportunity like to drop in the smoke and found Kratos.
Yeah, the thing is, Kutuzov, Chapayev can play really aggressive now.
Yep. They're already like pushing into B now, but they still need the smoke, otherwise someone you know like will do evil things to them.
Yeah, Kingpin I would like to see going left through the C-cap to have like different angle, And Hack XL needs to get
So, are you
into.
fucking eating while
Yeah.
casting? Dude, what the fuck?
Christmas.
That professionalism. Diano topping in there. Yeah, that is definitely forcing Fire Steve to leave there. I
He
can smoke
already
and.
spotted someone has hydro there.
Yeah, Diano. Hydro Tim. But.
Kingpin is now
Have they seen the
approach.
drops that are coming?
Yeah.
Okay.
He has to leave the smoke, there's no
Because there are like
choice.
two sets coming.
Ooh, that might be the end of Fire Steve.
Probably.
Yep.
Yeah, but the VDFF also got caught out by a Kingpin
Well, wasn't he
and
spotted?
Hex. Kingpin was spotted, yeah. Like, he was spotted, like, going around that corner. And now Diano is basically alone, but
They need to
Hex is
establish.
also getting dropped without any air support here.
Seems to be a thing here.
So.
This is a
Yeah, but.
really close game now.
Yep, it is. But Hex is apparently fully AA spec because, like, he murdered, like, one dive bomber squadron and the torpedo bomber squadron on his own. And they have actually shots on Yharnam.
Oh, there's the Chapire from the
There goes
Maraxi.
Limrox.
Oh, Hoshi
Okay.
ate a lot of damage as well, so that's not good.
Yeah, and Raven is at the moment like hydroed or whatever.
Yeah, but there's a Atago behind as well.
Yeah, but Raven is down. Jester was briefly up. Yeah,
Yeah.
okay. And Hellraiser avenges him.
That's awkward now.
It really is.
Hmm.
Like, the HP of the remaining, like, OP ships is kinda okay. And they're taking the second cap. But Skunk still has, like, both battleships.
Yeah,
And
Kingpin needs
it's.
to play super safe here. He can't lead because the Amagi is about like to look around.
Yeah, the Amagi is coming there. Oh, but Hellraiser just ate Citadels from Hex. Holy shit.
And if he can use this radar, then
Yeah,
these
I think.
both are pretty much
Like,
dead.
if Kingpin has his radar up, he should be able to kill either the Atago or the Liang.
Oh my god! Awareness, guys! Awareness! Awareness! There's a
Yeah, there was
battleship!
awareness for TOPS that are also now coming his way. He doesn't have his radar up. Like, he's trying to shoot something in the smoke that he can't see. Hitting Hellraiser now. Yeah, the TOPS are going to kill him.
Wow. That was a bit too aggressive by Kingpin here.
Yeah, he should have waited for Hex. His TOPS are out, but they're going to miss. Because they are spotted.
Wow, these games.
And this is making the game once again like way closer than it should have been.
Yeah,
Because if Kingpin would have been patient there, okay, I mean,
but now Dino is doing
Dino is
strange
probably dead
things.
because he's trapped between two Amagis.
Hoshi and the Charmatel can get the A cap if he's finding a position where he's
Can
safe.
also get the carrier for free then. Because Johanna's just below, like south of A.
So Psycho Eddie is having issues. Can he do something here?
Okay, Hoshi is actually going down.
The hell?
Someone you know, like got him
Okay, then it's
from there. So now it's looking really good for OP all of a sudden.
yeah.
Basically, yeah, if Kingpin would have been a bit more patient, or if like the command would have come for him, like wait for Hex, and they would have pushed together, that would have been like way better. Or waited for his radar even. I don't know if he had like one radar left, but should have.
Yeah, they were like that was, but I mean they had the time to do it. So
True.
yeah, Hacker is in an awkward spot now. But if he
Yeah.
stays angled, I think someone you know tries will try to ram him. That would be the best option.
Definitely. Like, Lutscher needs to get and help him.
Yeah,
Because
he
he
should
is.
have had prod side shots, easy.
Yeah.
Heck,
I don't know if he's still hoping for the Luoyang or for the Atago actually. No, he's turning around.
I mean, he can't shoot anything else.
Yeah, and Hex really doesn't want to get rammed here. Because then it's basically over.
Yeah, I think he should have just turned.
Yep, it's too late now. Yeah, I think somebody knows him for the ram. Yep.
Yeah, of course, because he slowed down that
much. Smart decision. Yeah, trading one for one. And that's leaving Skunk with only their one battleship. And the CV, of course.
Yeah, and no caps.
And no caps, and like only 90 points left on the board.
I think they can.
Lucha also eating a top here. Yeah. Like he can repair, but still.
The thing is, more experience paid off.
Yep, definitely. They were so close to having this. Like, this was like the one thing. Like the kingpin not waiting.
Yeah, that was the one thing. Literally a Haruki move by kingpin. He didn't think two steps ahead. Means
I don't know. Maybe someone told him go in there. Like could have been. We don't know.
But you. Then he would say, if I go in, then I'm facing an Amagi and the smoke, and I have no radar up. So everybody who, like, directs him to Amagi, there...
The Atago only, but still.
Yeah, the Amagi was about to come around, so there's no chance for him to... He can't go one versus one against the Amagi.
Yeah.
Well,
so OP continuing their streak, getting the points they want.
Yep.
So they're staying in first place. And, yeah, if Skunk wants... points, or at least 1 point, then they need to win the next game, definitely.
Lucha also 10 planes, sorry.
The Amagis did a pretty good AA job for Skunk. But yeah, Johanna won the carrier battle pretty convincingly this time. And someone you know with 4 kills.
Yeah, he did a great work there.
Like, that was very impressive and very important as well.
You can say that.
Like, yeah, he made all of the important kills. Also that he got the Charmatel, who was pushing A, that he got Hoshi.
Yeah,
because if Hoshi would have been allowed to survive and like roam free behind them, basically, and like take A away, that would have been... very disadvantageous for them.
Yeah, at least it would have given Skunk a bit more opportunities.
Yeah.
But, yeah. I think he was... Yeah, well, he was spotted all the time, so, yeah.
He was plane spotted, yeah.
That's a bit of an
issue. So, Johanna... I think that was also, like, self-preservation by Johanna, because he knew, like, okay, if this guy's coming my direction, I cannot really run away. So... Better tell my battleship, hey bro, I'm spotting for you, please delete.
Press please the delete this, button, yeah.
Yeah, please make this Charmatel go away. Okay, now we're going to see Haven. Bit of a different map because it's like way smaller than both the maps we've seen so far. I was just about to join like our training because I was so confused. But no, we are not training. We are actually casting.
We have a training?
Yes.
Ah, yeah, true. There was something like this.
It will be glorious because Asheville is playing carrier against Doiv.
Oh no.
Mhm.
Oh no.
Because I'm not there. So. It'll be pretty fun.
Yeah, so what did we learn? I think Skunk played quite well most of the time. The
just
issue is
like
their
one mistake
executions or decisions are not well not thought through sometimes, and that's the lack of experience.
Yeah, definitely. Like their radar chains and all of that is working very, very good. Also, the positioning of the Amagi of Hex, like when he was going around there and had basically 3 shots on all of the cruisers and also like Psycho Eddie dropping Kraton and all that, that worked out beautifully. The only issue arose basically when the game fell a bit apart when they were too sure, okay, now we've got this. I think that was like the issue, bit of overexcitement, and then okay, and suddenly you don't have the game anymore.
Yeah, Kingpin was like this. Whoever was calling the shots there, or if he decided by himself, that might have cost them the game, that move.
Thing is, if he has actually, like, if he would have had radar, everything would have been fine. So exactly. I don't know if he was completely out of radars, but he shouldn't have been at the time. Like, he should have had one last radar left.
I doubt that he would have been out of radar, or he was out of radar.
So, and because then the Luoyang as well as the Atago would have been up, and the Atago was on like 3k. So that's an easy kill even for like the Chapayev on like 6 kilometer range.
Yeah, and the next thing was like Heck not realizing that someone, you know, just needs to ram him
I think he was like kind of hoping on the Atago that he was like waiting in B, but the Atago just like said no and like dropped off to the C cap. And then they were fine there.
Yeah, I think the quick decisions that have to be made in these situations that are not I couldn't see it on Skunk's side, but this is, as I just said, a lack of experience. Because yep. okay, they brought the Charmatel to A. That was a smart move, but of course he should have been undetected. Would have not cost his life. And the other thing was like the Amagi above B, he was practically useless at the end.
Yeah, he was in, at the start he was in the direction of A, and then they saw, okay, we cannot hold A because we lost our Akizuki there in the beginning, like super fast, so we cannot do anything because we've got no spotting whatsoever. And then he turned back basically. That's why he was above B. Like, he wasn't supposed to be there. The original idea was to send him like next to A together with the Charles, but that didn't like work out when the Akizuki died, because then from then on they had to run. That was like the big issue there.
Yeah, indeed. But yeah.
Okay, let's wait for Haven.
Still no Ream up.
Actually fucking surprised that our room is completely full, so we have apparently a lot of spectators.
I'm saying hello. Hello! Comrade Storm. Nice name.
It was also quite surprising that Diano survived the two Amagis in the end. Like, he was on 600 HP or something?
Well, he hugged the island pretty smart there, so...
Yeah, but, like, they had shots on him, and then Hex, like, basically continued to push on. If he hadn't done that, he would have been in trouble.
Yeah, true.
No?
They forgot us.
The room up already? No room.
Yeah. What can we talk about now?
Maybe we can talk a bit more about the patch that's coming.
Yeah, I think you're better informed than I am, so...
Yeah, well, you're not informed at all, so...
Exactly. Also, I'm potatoing a lot of stuff, so...
Yeah, no, the patch. They are buffing low-tier premium camos. Like, at the moment, most of the low-tier premium camos are just, like, the perma camos. They're just giving, like, 30% XP. And they are going to be buffed for all of them up to 50%. So you might want to play your Ishitsushi again in the future.
Yeah.
So, because you don't want to buy a key, you can use that as your like trainer for battleships.
Actually, I don't need a trainer because I just generate Captain XP, Elite Captain.
Okay,
XP
map is up by the way. And then but we are on neighbors for some reason. No, this is fucking wrong. That was the wrong thingy that I joined there. Skunk was OP there. I want to join.
So P side this time.
So yeah, that's going to change, to be changed, like the camos. What else is going to change? Yeah, Kutuzov and Belfast are like no longer on sale.
Yeah, because it's a significant change with the smoke.
Yeah, and they don't want the backlash they had after the safe firing change for DDs, where people were like complaining, yeah, I bought the Anshan and the Bliska specifically, or the Luyang as well, specifically because they could stealth fire. And they didn't offer a refund at that time. And this time it's going to be like this. They are vanishing from the store. The Kutuzov and Belfast, most likely never to be sold ever again. At least that's what they said in the official video.
Never be sold again?
Yes.
The Belfast.
Belfast and Kutuzov. And the Perf is probably coming back later into the store. So it might be, yeah, that we are never going to see these ships again, like, after the current population.
Yeah, the fun part is you can also sell your Belfast or Kutuzov because...
Yeah, you can sell them and you get doubloons, like, no real money, but at least you get doubloons back. Okay, lineups. Both teams running two Amagis again, and then Skunk is going with double Char Motel this time, one Chapaifan Kutuzov, and Akizuki and Luoyang. And OP just keeping the current lineup. Atago, Chapaev, Kutuzov, and Akizuki W. Young. That seems to work out for them. They have not deviated from it.
Of course, this map has no tournament mode, right?
Apparently not. So I guess we just sit still. And wait for our end.
Johannes is making a joke here.
But this is he just doesn't want to shoot me. Skunk, please. Somebody.
Did you route them?
Yeah. Okay. Jester is shooting, but he's not hitting.
That's not so good.
No. Kingpin. There we go. Okay, so apparently we have found like one of the maps that doesn't have tournament mode, actually.
I don't know if the... I am not sure.
Or maybe it wasn't like implemented there. We don't know. So, looks like a really strong B push here.
By the way, in addition, what I just wrote in my chat, Kingpin said that his radar ran out.
Ah, okay, so he had no more radar. Okay, then, yeah. Then it's kind of difficult for him. Yeah, it looks like a really strong B push for Skunk. Basically, only a Charmatel and like Hoshi and Hex. They are going outside of C, like above to the north. And every other ship is either going into B or on the other side. Like, we have two roaming Amagi and Charmatel groups. Lucha and Dilmarax on one side, and Hoshi and Hex on the other.
Yeah, this central position there for Chapayev is pretty prominent.
Yeah, that's Kingpin. He is sitting there with the Kutuzov and has the Luoyang in front.
Yeah, and so... Chapai from OP is moving to the island between B and C, so nothing really special because that are the usual positions.
And yeah, Ekolon also now turning in towards B. Johanov, a pretty even fight against Psycho Eddie above here.
Jester spotted.
Yep. And because he's probably pushing in there. Like, no, there's AA fighting going on, like crazy.
Oh, yeah. In Jester's position, I would have waited until this is over.
I mean, he is behind the island node, so I'm not sure if he can actually be shot anymore.
Nope.
But there is a probably top drop coming in from Johanna. Don't know if Psycho AD can intercept fast enough.
And long range drop? Long range drop, nice.
Yeah, was the best he could do because, like, the fighters were almost on him.
Yeah, almost get panicked.
And it's forcing him to move, basically.
He will.
Not nope. Eating a top, but still getting dive bombed. And I'm not sure if, like, maybe the Tuzov or something or Artago has shots on him.
Yep.
Killed his engine and took like 1.5k.
If he's got spotted again,
then there's trouble, yeah.
Diano is just waiting below the B cap.
Okay.
Maybe reversing into it, but it take like 2 minutes. Because the distance he's like reversing is a bit.
Yeah, probably going for it like super safe.
Yeah, but makes sense. I mean, Jester lost half HP for not being super safe.
Lilrock's already got punished a bit.
Okay. Now the it's getting a bit like tricky because Echelon also moved in to B.
Yep.
Means he AA moved support the for the Lo Yang Jester.
Yo, but he is getting hit by the Amagi at the moment. From the other side of the map, basically, from behind C. Because he was radared, I guess. By Honrubia.
Hmm.
And yeah, Jester is deciding, okay, this is like enough for me here. Let's go.
And they need the smoke for the Chapayev and the
Kutuzov. Yeah, definitely. There. Otherwise, that's going to be not a good position for him. Echelon is spotted?
No.
He is?
Just blind shooting. Now he's spotted.
Okay. If so, that was pretty good blind spot, like blind shooting because he lost like 3.4k?
Yeah, of course, because he couldn't go anywhere else.
Now he's trapped there.
Yep. Another well played by OP.
Yep.
Yeah, okay. Echelon
No, he's realizing it. Like, better use my smoke.
He's still spotted? Radar, probably?
Hydro?
Oh, Hydro. Ooh.
Yeah, like they're really catching him out here.
But Raven also ate a ton of damage there. But in the end, if they can... I mean, they chunked both of their DDs.
Yeah, both of the DDs of Skunk are once again like below 50%.
Yeah, if you have a 2 DD setup, you want to play ultra safe, and especially that's what they were doing. I mean, of course, these islands look super safe, but they aren't actually. Because
if you have like Amagi on the other side of the map, like Pac-Man, and he's just shooting you from there.
Exactly, and yeah. Also, the issue with the Hydro is the thing.
Yep.
That ran off.
Yeah, I think Echelon is now trying to leave this, but it will be hard because he's going to be air-spotted.
Yeah, there's some coordination.
Like, Johanna is happily sacrificing planes if he can get rid of Echelon for the trade.
Yeah, that was too early. He should have waited until Psycho Eddie has... he has no way that he comes out of there.
1k.
Johanna is spotting him.
Atago Salvo burning, goodbye. No, still alive.
Johanna will sacrifice his fighters for it.
Yeah, he has to.
Yep.
Diano securing the kill. So there goes Echelon. Trapped into B, and yeah, it turned out to be a death trap for him.
Yeah, as I said, you can't do this with Liu Yang's around carriers. That's why this map is so, like, difficult to play.
Yep, it really is. Like you said, the islands, they look safe, and then it turns out they are not.
They are not a single bit now. While Lucha and I think it's Hoshi again are pushed away to the north.
That's Hex. Hex and Hoshi. Hex that group.
And
Hoshi.
Okay.
And Limerax and Lucha are the other group on the other side.
Ah, okay. Limerax, okay.
Jester also spotted, air spot.
Yeah, that's not going the right way for Skunk here. So far, OP is playing this down really calm.
Yeah. Jester is really, really in trouble here. Like, he's constantly air spotted.
Actually, there's no need right now for them to get the now it's...
No, they're contesting B, yeah. Because there's nothing there anymore that can, like, block the cap for them. They can just take it.
Lucha gets dropped. Yep. Oh, Lil Murax ate a lot of damage there.
Yeah, he ate before. Like, that's... Okay, but Lucha took it. Oh, he actually had a flooding. Because he just used his repair.
So far I don't see...
Like, Skunk is just losing on all fronts at the moment. Like, they're slowly but surely, like, the air to breathe is getting, like, less and less. Yep, pretty nice shot by someone, you know, like Honrubia timed it with the radar. So he was just in range, like 200 meters in range.
Yeah, today is a totally different picture. It seems as if OP has Skunk totally under control, while Skunk had PTS totally under control on Sunday.
So OP definitely has the number of Skunk here, like that's... But it like confirms like their top dog position of in the league.
Yeah.
Like League 3 is their house at the moment, and so after this I'm pretty convinced that they're like going to like move up into second league.
Yeah, I think so too. I mean, this is pretty convincing actually.
Like there's not much that Skunk can do.
From
this position at the moment, like nothing at all.
And they need to do something means yeah. Kill ships.
Raven being pointed out there, but still, like, he can just smoke up now. There's no Chapaev anymore to radar him. And they're taking, like, B as well now.
Yeah, it's a prime example why you want to play ultra safe with 2DDs.
Mm-hmm. I mean, they kind of tried. They tried to get the Luoyang and the Akizuki together. But the timing was a bit off, so that first one of them got chunked down, and then the other one entered, and one of them, like the Luoyang, then had to move out of the cap, and suddenly the Akizuki was left alone in a position that was not feasible for him.
And
that was like the big problem there.
Hack is flooding and burning.
Yeah.
It's not the best thing you want to have if you want to do an offensive move there.
Definitely not.
Yeah. Luoyang is torping.
Jester. Whoa, that was close. Jester barely survived those torps.
Uh-oh. Do you see what I see?
Hoshi is in a bit of trouble.
Yep.
Maybe not.
Oh, nice dodge there, but...
But yeah, Hex basically pushed him in, used him as a torp belt. Like the extended torp belt. I mean, not much he could do about it either.
So that was like...
Someone you know might maybe die, because Lucha is now like pushing him, and I don't know how much backup he has.
Literally nothing.
So, yeah. They're probably going to chunk him down with, like, HE. But even then, the advantage that OP has already, like, it's not going away. Like, three caps and the important kills.
Oh.
Like, the Chapaev and the Akizuki. Yeah, someone you know is dead now. Like, next servo.
Yeah, I mean, doesn't matter.
Oh. Just even like Psycho Eddie gets. Okay, Lucha stole the kill there from Psycho Eddie because the fire was going to tick. Yeah, but.
What is Jester? OP doing now? I mean.
Actually, it's not necessary. They don't need to do anything, that's the thing. Let's see if they actually like manage to throw this.
They're just doing it for us, I guess.
Hellraiser is visible at the moment and they cannot like spot back.
Yeah.
That's an issue. Also, Akizuki and Lo Yang are there.
Oh my god. Is OP showing us what not to do?
Throwing the last game? Let's see, yeah, there goes Hellraiser. Okay, okay. Maybe a bit too overconfident with the push there. Like, there's still a Kutuzov and a Lo Yang in that smoke.
Is Diano still spotted? No.
No, no, they're safe now. But they should not, like, push in there again.
Torps nasty coming. Torps. No, Hoshi is dead.
For Hoshi, yeah, he is going to eat a lot of them. Okay. Those are really nice Torps by Yanil.
Yeah, and Hex, I think Hex is also eating some.
Nope, because they're in out.
It were Kutuzov Torps then, I guess.
Yep. Probably. Whoa! Okay. Okay.
Man, you were not angled enough.
Hex just showed him, like, no. You might be an Amagi, but you still have a Citadel. And I know where it is. Wow. Let's see if he can finish him off, actually.
That's an issue, actually.
Because then they have lost both their battleships. No, okay. And now Pac-Man is, like, taking revenge. And getting smoked up. Yeah, and thing is, the points. Yep. Like, there are only like 30 points left.
And hey, Kutuzov is going into B now, that makes sense.
Ooh, Pac-Man? Nope.
Wow!
Kratos.
Also.
He was almost.
Oh my god.
Gone.
Pac-Man is here at 500 hit points.
Yeah, I think Hex really wants to blind fire into that smoke at the moment. Like, the only issue is if, like, Fire Steve goes down, because, like, he is super aggressive now.
Hey, he's right, he needs to do something. If he can take out ships,
it's... Yeah, there goes Pac-Man, so the blind fire succeeded there.
Whoa.
Like, OP? Are you really throwing this away? Raven? Going to be the next guy who's going to go down.
Wow.
There we go.
Wow.
And if Fire Steve has some way to survive this, I'm not sure about that, but
this is
like if he can survive
doable.
This
is actually doable.
There's Diano.
But Fire Steve is going like a bit.
Yeah.
No, he will eat Torps.
Will he?
No, he's not. Wow.
Yeah, but the Chapayev is still there. And Chapayev can shoot Jester.
Steve is down, but still.
What's happening on the other side? Herr Hex might eat Torps. Oh, he turned too early, too soon.
Steve is surviving this in a way.
Yeah, but Hex is going down now.
The Chapayev also.
Rubia, but, yeah, but okay.
Oh wow, how can Hex die?
He turned too early into the Torps.
Yeah, that's a lack of spotting.
Oh, but Yanil is also on 300 HP. So if Psycho Eddie gets this drop off in
Nimarax
a good way...
is coming now as well.
Whoa. He dodged that one? What is happening here? Like, this is suddenly...
Nimarax a bit unlucky.
Yeah. You know, like, dodging for his life at the moment?
Nope.
Okay.
Wow.
So,
How to throw games one.
Somehow OP just demonstrated in the last 5 minutes how you can basically throw a game away when you're like too aggressive and keep pushing into smoke. That's basically what we mentioned before, what you mentioned. You don't want to push with the current meta.
He can't drop, I guess. And he did drop already.
Yeah, but he just needs to spot, like, Diano, like, it's over. There's no way they can win this now.
That's so hilarious. Can you believe this?
Okay, Hellraiser had a bad connection. Apparently, but still, like, this was... This was interesting. So, Skunk getting the point they wanted and, like, handed on a silver platter, basically. They just had to grab it and, like, take it.
Yeah, this is really how to throw games.
I mean, even if Hellraiser had like the disconnection issue and like had bad ping after that, like still, the way they pushed in there, that was like way too aggressive.
Yeah, I'm just astonished in a way because what the hell?
Like,
I mean, if you want to be aggressive and wrap it up, then you play smart and not like, bring yourself on the silver tablet to the enemy to shoot you death to death.
Yeah, that was basically what, like, it started with the Atago and then as well as someone you know, like, having no support on the A side.
Yeah, he overextended.
Like, on the western side. Because he was totally alone against the Charmatel and the Amagi all of a sudden, who just... switched, like, they remembered suddenly, hey, we have this other ammo as well, like, it's called HE, we can just burn him down. That's what they did.
Great stuff, man.
Then it was also, like, super well played by Skunk in the last,
yeah,
like,
fire,
five, who was like, fire after Hex died, they didn't lose another ship. So, that was really, really well executed, the counter push in the end. So, congratulations to OP for winning the overall thing, still. Like, they are getting the 3 points. Actually, going into the league now. So, OP is at 15 points now. They are, securely in first place. And Skunk is getting 1 point, so they are moving up to second place for the moment. But the other teams still have to play this week. So it's very unlikely that they're going to stay there. We don't actually know who is playing who against this week because the league schedule is looking like this at the moment. Meaning we don't have any way like to check who is playing against each other.
Well, Skunk it's played against PTS.
That was last week.
OP played already against Darkside Wars.
Mm-hmm.
So. Yeah, so OP didn't play against PTS yet.
Okay, so that's one possible opponent.
Yeah, but they won against DSW. And they played against MFG. Give me a quick, check. And they won against MFG as well. So unless OP is doing stupid things, they might have a significant lead here.
Yep. Yeah, but like I'm still a bit stunned by the last game, but it was super entertaining at the end. Like in between, I thought, okay, what am I going to say, like talk about for the next like 5 minutes until this game ends because nothing is going to happen. And yeah, then it kinda went in a totally different direction there.
Yeah, I guess they just made it for us a bit more entertaining.
Yep. If so, thank you very much. It was super entertaining actually, but like the other games were entertaining as well. So, thanks again for letting us stream this. And thanks for watching.
Yeah, also, again, I want to apologize for, like, fucking up the first game by having on the browser.
It wouldn't be one of your streams if you didn't fuck it up.
Yeah, Snipechat also said something like that. He is totally right. I mean, can you remember? On Sunday, I was totally wasted from Saturday and everything went fine. So, total perfect stream. Yeah, and... now I'm sober. I should drink, I think. It's like...
like I told you, being like becoming like a raging alcoholic when this season is over, and then towards the next season you're like casting from the like hospital or something when you are getting a new liver.
The regeneration season then.
Anyway, I think that wraps it up for the evening. Yeah. Maybe we can get one more game. We don't know yet.
Yeah, on Friday, I guess.
If we find the time.
Some game on Friday, I think. Friday, okay. There is no Clan Wars available, so might be so that Friday.
We might cast the game on Friday. Let's see what league. Then, yeah, thanks for watching.
Yeah, also want to mention, I will upload it on YouTube and I will re-commentate the first game. Yeah, sadly without Seka then, but yeah.
You can just use the audio.
Yeah, or you can just do this, yeah.
Just extract that and slap that over the replay. Done. Okay, then I think we're done for the day.
Yeah, we are.
Have a nice evening, everybody. Thanks for watching again. And hopefully see you on Friday.
Same for me. Yeah, hope to see you around soon. And till next time.